Hello everyone, welcome to Historically Accurate. If you follow science and technology news, you may have heard of some Chinese science and technology projects over the years. Bei Dou, Tian Gong, Shen Zhou, Chang’e, and so on. If you are not familiar with Chinese culture, you may find these names very strange, but in fact,There are some interesting origins and stories behind these names. In this episode, I will tell you about the origins of the names of these science and technology projects. The first project that I want to talk about is China's crewed spacecraft project, Shen Zhou. Shen Zhou literally means the magical boat of the Milky Way, which perfectly fits the purpose of this crewed spacecraft.In addition, Shen Zhou and Shen Zhou are homophones. Shen Zhou is the name of the first nine provinces of the Chinese civilization. Therefore, it also symbolically represents China. Because of these reasons, Shen Zhou was chosen as the name of the crewed spacecraft. The Shen Zhou 1 spacecraft entered space in 1999.And the Shen Zhou 5 spacecraft successfully carried an astronaut into space in 2003. It has been 18 years since then, but I feel as if it just happened not long ago. Time flies. The second project that I want to talk about is the Chinese Lunar Exploration Program, the Chang'e Project. In Chinese mythology, Chang'e was the wife of Hou Yi,and Hou Yi was considered to be the greatest archer of all time. Legend has it that 10 suns appeared in the sky in ancient times. The temperature on the earth became so hot that all plants and animals were dying and rivers were drying up. Seeing the destructions that the suns were causing, Hou Yi stepped in and shut down 9 suns with his bow and arrows.The earth finally became suitable for life again. Hou Yi saved the life on the earth, therefore he was respected and admired by people. Many people also came to him to learn archery. One day, Hou Yi met the Queen Mother of the West, the supreme goddess in Chinese mythology, who gave him an elixir of immortality. Hou Yi didn't want to abandon his wife and become an immortal himself.So he asked Chang'e to take care of the elixir. One day, when Hou Yi was out hunting, Peng Meng, one of Hou Yi's apprentices, led a group of people to force Chang'e to hand over the elixir. Seeing that the elixir was about to be snatched by Peng Meng, Chang'e simply ate it herself. After eating the elixir, Chang'e involuntarily drifted to the moon,and lived in the Guanghan Palace on the moon from then on. Only Yu Tu, the jade rabbit, responsible for pounding medicine, accompanied Chang'e as a pet in the Guanghan Palace. Since then, Chang'e has become the moon goddess in Chinese culture. Knowing this story, we can easily understand why Chinese Lunar Exploration Program is also called the Chang'e Project. On December the 14th, 2013, the Chang'e 3 lunar probe successfully landed on the moon with the lunar rover, named Yu Tu, and began its exploration mission. The landing site of Yu Tu has been named Guanghan Palace. Although encountered operational difficulties during its mission, Yu Tu lunar rover continued to operate until July 2016. In January 2019,The Chang'e 4 lunar probe successfully landed on the far side of the moon with the lunar rover named Yu Tu 2. Since direct communication with the Earth is impossible on the far side of the moon, a relay satellite named Qiao Qiao, Magpie Bridge, was launched to transfer data between the Earth and the Chang'e 4 as well as the Yu Tu 2.There is also a romantic story behind the name Qiao Qiao. A long time ago, there was a man named Niu Lang, the cowherd. His parents died young and he was often abused by his elder brother and sister-in-law. he only had an old ox to keep him company. One day, he ran into the granddaughter of the Emperor of Heaven, Zhi Nu, the weaver girl. Zhi Nu was good at weaving, and she weaved rosy clouds in the sky every day. Tired of weaving, she sneaked off to the mortal world and ran into Niu Lang. Niu Lang and Zhi Nu fell in love with each other at first sight, and Zhi Nu married Niu Lang secretly. The Emperor of Heaven was enraged by what Zhi Nu had done and forcibly brought Zhi Nu back to heaven. He only allowed them to meet in the sky on the seventh day of the seventh month of the lunar calendar every year. However, due to the Milky Way in the sky, Niu Lang and Zhi Nu couldn't see each other. So the magpies from the mortal world would fly up to the Milky Way and build a bridge with their bodies so that Niu Lang and Zhi Nu could meet. Therefore, the seventh day of the seventh month of the lunar calendar, which is the Qixi festival, has become the Chinese Valentine's Day. Que Qiao, namely a bridge built by magpies as a symbol of connection and communication, was a perfect name for the relay satellite. In Chinese mythology, Tian Gong, Heavenly Palace, was a palace complex where the Emperor of Heaven lived. There were 36 palaces and 72 halls in it. Guanghan Palace was one of the 36 palaces. So, what project would be a good option to be named after Tian Gong? I think you have guessed the answer. It is the Chinese Space Station program. China has previously launched Tiangong 1 and Tiangong 2 space stations. Tiangong 1 lifted off in September 2011, ended data services in March 2016, and re-entered the atmosphere in April 2018. Tiangong 2 lifted off in September 2016 and re-entered the atmosphere in July 2019. Although they hadn't been in space for a long time, they had all successfully completed their assigned tasks. I hope that the future Tiangong space stations will serve mankind in space forever, just like the Tiangong in Chinese mythology. In December 2015, China launched a dark matter particle explorer named Wukong. The name Wukong also has a long history. There is an ancient Chinese fantasy novel, Journey to the West, which tells the story of a monk named Tang Sanzang leading his three disciples to ancient India to obtain Buddhist scriptures. Among the three disciples, Sun Wukong had many superpowers. He could transform into various figures or animals and was able to travel 108,000 li in one somersault. He also had a pair of Huoyan Jingjing, golden gaze fiery eyes, which allowed him to identify monsters or immortals even after they transformed into other figures, animals, or objects. Naming the dark matter particle explorer Wukong shows that the Chinese people hope the explorer can work like Wukong's Huoyan Jingjing to identify the dark matter with even the least evidence. Bei Dou 3 navigation satellite system, which is China's high-precision GPS, officially started operating in July 2020. Bei Dou literally means Northern Dipper, and it is the name given by ancient Chinese astronomers to the seven brightest stars in the constellation Ursa Major. In ancient China, people used these seven stars to find the North Star so that they could determine the direction. Therefore, the word Bei Dou gradually came to have the meaning of pointing the direction. It is quite appropriate to name the navigation satellite system after Bei Dou. China also has a Kuafu solar monitoring satellite project. This project was to use three satellites to monitor the sun's activities around the clock. However, it has been put on hold due to the funding problems. The name of the project, Kuafu, is the name of the person in Chinese mythology. Kuafu was the leader of the Kuafu clan during the era of the Yellow Emperor. There was once a serious drought, and the Kua Fu clan went out in search of water, but couldn't find any. Kua Fu became furious and swore to chase the sun and plunk it down. However, he died of exhaustion in the end, and his body turned into the Kua Fu mountains. The story of Kua Fu chasing the sun reflects the desire of ancient Chinese ancestors to conquer nature. It is also appropriate to name the solar monitoring satellite project after Kua Fu. These are the Chinese mythologies that I want to share with you in this episode. I chose them because they have considerable influence not only on the names selected for those Chinese science and technology projects, but also on the Chinese culture overall. If you have any thoughts and suggestions, please leave your comments below. If you like my video, please like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. See you next time!